In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at the live visualization feature within Viral and how, with topologies that you've built and configured yourself, you're able to then bring the live visualization capabilities into play. The live visualization feature requires IP-based out-of-band management. So when we're bringing up a new topology with a design like I'm showing you here on the screen, what I need to create to start off with is that basic management infrastructure. So the way that we can do this is by using AutoNetKit not to generate the full configurations for us, but here, by disabling the address family, by disabling routing, we're just going to get it to create the management infrastructure that we need. So now I'm passing my topology to AutoNetKit to build the configurations, and we're going to take a look at what it's actually creating for us. So I've selected my node and clicking on the configuration tab, we can now see that there is configuration being created, but that with the interfaces, there's no IP address being set up on them. There's also no routing protocol created, but the default users that we need are present. Here again, we see the interfaces, no IP addresses created. I'm now ready to start my topology. And we're going to speed things up a bit as these virtual machines then come up into life. So my VM is now coming active. Now with this topology, what I'm intending to do is to configure three nodes with OSPF and three nodes with EIGRP. And of course, I'm doing this by hand. I'm not using AutoNetKit to do this. So we're just going to log in. This node's still booting right now. If we take a look at the configuration, we can see that we have the bare bones configuration, but there is now on that interface a management IP address that's been injected. And this is what we need for the live visualization capability. So now I'm ready to actually start doing my configuration. And as you'd imagine, this is going to be fairly long and boring, so we're going to fast forward in a moment and we'll come back and take a look at what I've built. Okay, so we've now got this node into a configured state. So we can look at the configuration, and here we can see now I've got my addressing in place, my loopbacks, and I've now got infrastructure links in place, and I've done all this configuration, as I said, by hand using my own addressing scheme, not something that's come from AutoNetKit. So with these links that are going across the top, I'm using different addressing spaces. Now if we look at the routing table, here we can see we've got a number of infrastructure links in the 100-200 range, the cross-links for the 80-80 range, and we're just going to take a look at another one of the nodes. Again, this is one of these borders between OSPF on the one side and EIGRP on the other. So we can see my addressing is there. You can see my OSPF neighbors are up. And again, we'll take a quick look at the running config, my loopbacks, my infrastructure links, again with my addressing scheme, and also the cross links are there again with the 8080 addresses. I want to highlight a new feature in VM Maestro, which is turning on the interface names in our diagram, so we can then see, as we're configuring, the names associated to all the various links, which is very helpful. So taking a look at this particular node, and again, we can see I've put all my addressing in place using a different address range, because this is my EIGRP area. And again, here's the configuration that I've built up using my addressing schema. The only piece that's coming in is that management IP that we need for the live visualization capability. So here we can see EIGRP configured. We've got some static routes that I'm using for advertising my cross links. Just logging into another one of the nodes. Again, there's loopback and our management IP. And we can see the 5100 networks that I'm using there. And again, the 8080 network being used for the cross connects. And if I look in my routing table, we can see all the various entries, of course. Those EX routes coming across through the static routes that I've added in. And here I'm just adding in the final pieces in order to get connectivity all the way across. And those are going to be redistributed into EIGRP. So the 192.168.10 network are the loopback address range I've used in my OSPF area, and the 100.200, the infrastructure links that I've used over there. So just finish off the configuration by redistributing those static routes. And then we're going to take a look from iOS v6 and take a look at the routing table there. So here we can see we've now got some parallel paths. If we pick up this particular prefix, we can see that we're going via iOS v4 and via iOS v5. So now we're going to do a trace route. And we can see that we've got parallel paths that are present and active there. So I'm happy with my configuration and I want to save that. So I'm going to do extract configuration, and it's going to reach into the various nodes, save the configuration back. And there we go, we're done. So if we now review the configuration, we can now see, back in the configuration tab, the full configuration that I applied with all my addressing, my static routes, etc. There's a node with EIGRP. Again, my addressing structure, my static routes in there. So in this example, I'm using the UWM interface to launch my simulation. That's the one that we just saw me designing earlier. And I've launched the live visualization function. So as my network is coming up, the system is busy polling the various devices. You can see the state messages changing here. And it's trying to log in, which is why we need that management configuration being created and default user entries. So it's going to keep on retrying until these devices finish booting. And there we go, now seeing reachable messages coming through. And it's now starting to gather information. And we can see that as all the devices are coming up, the data is being gathered and is being processed. So the live visualization feature also includes a centralized syslog function. So from our actions button, we can then send in the request to configure syslog. So the system will reach into each of the nodes, set up a syslog entry, and now we get our messages being sent through to our central processor. So as changes are occurring in the network, we now have a God's eye view of what's happening in the network. Bringing an interface down, we can see it directly as the syslog messages are coming up. Link going down, again, we can see the impact, OSPF indicating that the interface has gone down. Interface back up. And then we'll see OSPF coming up. So here I've logged into the node. And I'm actually going to bring one of the interfaces down. And again, if we look in our syslog, we can see that resultant message interface back up. And once more, we see the resultant message. Grab the routing table, and we can see it in our log. So from each one of our nodes, rather than having to run around and log into each one individually. Now we want to see our routing protocols at work. So OSPF, we can see the gathering data there, EIGRP, And again, we can see the processing of the messages there. And here we can see we've brought an interface down, so EIGRP is now reflecting that state. Bring the interface back up. Now we're going to do a trace route from one device to another. And here we can even see how that path was achieved. Shut the interface down, send the trace route through again. And there we can see it taking the alternate path. So now we're going to do a trace. Of course, it hasn't reconverged yet. We do it again. Now we can see it takes a normal path. So shut that interface down. Again, we see the messages in the syslog. Wait for convergence to occur. And then it takes the normal path as one would expect. So we'll do a few more trace routes just for fun. These highlighting the fact that we've got dual paths in place. Do a few more. Hopefully this then highlights to you the fact that this tool can work with configurations that you've created. It's able to learn the network using the topologies that you've built, the configurations that you've applied, and then you can bring these tools to bear so you can see the impact on your network as you make changes, as you reconfigure, as you bring interfaces up and down.